बीए पार्ट फर्स्ट के विद्यार्थियों का एक बार फिर से स्वागत। प्रिय विद्यार्थियों, इससे पहले के वीडियो में हमने बात की थी जॉन मिल्टन, इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द पोएट एंड शॉर्ट इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द पोएम और सोनेट ऑन हिज ब्लाइंडनेस। प्रिय विद्यार्थियों, आज के वीडियो में हम बात करेंगे ए शॉर्ट समरी ऑफ द पोएम ऑन हिज ब्लाइंडनेस। जॉन मिल्टन्स पोएम ऑन हिज ब्लाइंडनेस इज एन ऑटोबायोग्राफिकल सोनेट इन विच मिल्टन मेडिटेट्स ऑन हिज ओन लॉस ऑफ साइट। फॉर मोस्ट ऑफ हिज लाइफ मिल्टन हैड बीन एबल टू सी परफेक्टली, बट हिज लेट नाइट रीडिंग एंड राइटिंग ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ द शॉर्ट लाइव्ड इंग्लिश रिपब्लिक इन विच ही हेल्ड ए वेरी प्रोमिनियंट पोजिशन हेल्प्ड रुइन हिज आई साइट। दिस सोनेट रिटन इन द पेट्रार्कल राइमिंग स्कीम एसोसिएटेड विद द 14th सेंचुरी इटेलियन पोएट फ्रांसिस्को पेट्रार्का इज डिवाइडेड इन टू 8 लाइन ऑक्टेव एंड ए 6 लाइन सेस्टेट। द ऑक्टेव राइम ए बी बी ए बी बी ए एंड द सेस्टेट राइम्स सी डी ई सी डी ई। द सोनेट इज देयर फॉर ए टिपिकल पेट्रार्कन सोनेट इन फॉर्म, बट इन सब्जेक्ट मैटर द पोएम डिपार्ट्स फ्रॉम द टॉपिक्स usually associated with the Petrarchan poems. Petrarch, the English version of Petrarch's name, was most famous for writing about love. Milton departs from that conventional topic to deal with a very practical, very physical problem, but a problem with many broader spiritual implications. By beginning line one with the word when, Milton immediately signals that he is opening with a subordinate clause that introduces the main idea to follow. Beginning the poem this way creates a certain suspense. The main idea is postponed so that we have to continue reading in anticipation of its eventual arrival. Shakespeare also often used this kind of sentence pattern in constructing his own sonnets. By opening with a dependent clause, Milton heightens our sense of anticipation by delaying the key statement. The word consider implies careful, rational thought that rather than purely emotional reaction. Here and throughout the poem, the speaker uses his reason, which Renaissance Christians considered one of the greatest gifts that God had bestowed upon human beings. The ability of humans to reason, they believed, linked them to God and distinguished them from animals. The speaker feels that his light is spent, extinguished in several sense of the word light. This word clearly alludes, at least eventually, to the speaker's loss of sight. But light may also suggest one's own intelligence. The opening line may at first seem to mean, when I think how I have used my intelligence. But it soon comes to mean, when I ponder how my ability to see has become extinguished. This later meaning is, of course, foreshadowed by the poem's title. The idea of losing one's sight is obviously a deeply troubling one. The blind person is suddenly at risk in all kinds of ways. The speaker in the poem feels vulnerable. He can no longer literally see his own way or easily protect himself from dangers. The special tragedy of this particular speaker is that he has lost his sight at an unusually early stage of life. Rather than becoming blind when elderly, he has become blind in middle age. He now inhabits a world that seems dark in at least two senses. It is no longer physically visible, and it is a world full of sin and spiritual darkness. The world, moreover, is not only dark but also white. The speaker will somehow have to navigate both literally and figuratively in a world which, in On His Blindness, the writer John Milton talks openly about losing his eyesight, an event which began in 1640s as a result of his heavy workload. Milton was completely blind by 1652. In the first few lines of the poem, Milton reflects on losing his sight before he reached middle age and describes how this world has become totally dark. For Milton, this is particularly concerning because he now wonders how he will serve God, his master. Especially, he wonders if God expects him to do day labor every day. Everyday task while he is in darkness. As Milton ponders these questions, patience, personified here as a living person, interjects his thoughts and softly reminds him that God does not need Milton to do anything. In fact, patience tells him that the best way to serve God is just accept life for what it is, since that is God's will. Finally, Milton is also reminded that God has plenty of people to run around and carry out his errands. More importantly, Milton should wait patiently and trust that God will know the best way to use him and his blindness. So, Priya Vidyarthiyon, this was a brief introduction or a brief summary of the poem On His Blindness. Or we can say the poem is about the poet himself. Milton has become blind. He is about 44 years old. The world appears dark and gloomy to him. He finds that he cannot make use of the talent of writing poetry given to him by God. He cannot write poetry since he is blind. He fears that God will rebuke him for wasting the talent given to him. But he is helpless. He asks questions: Doth God exact day labor, light denied. He feels it is wrong to expect him to write poetry now. Soon Milton realizes that this is a foolish question. God does not expect his gifts back. He does not want to do something for him. He has thousands of angels to serve him day and night. He only wants us to have unquestioning faith in his wisdom. God is like a king. He has thousands of angels to serve him. Those people who only stand and wait also serve God. What is required in faith in God's? What is required is faith in God's wisdom and action. So, dear student, this was a brief summary of the poem or the sonnet on his blindness.